What is the difference between pulp heroes and comic book heroes? Today, you're gonna find out. Hey guys, welcome back to Comic Gen TV, where all geek culture collides. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on future videos. Today, we're taking a look at the difference between pulp heroes and comic book heroes. First, before we get into that, let's answer the question, what are pulps? The short answer is that pulps were inexpensive fiction magazines that were published from 1896 up through the 1950s on cheap wood pulp paper and typically had 128 pages at 7 inches wide by 10 inches tall with very ragged, untrimmed edges. The long answer, however, is all that, but also they were very low-quality literature. The first was Frank Muncy's Argosy magazine from 1896. It had 135,000 words, 192 pages with no illustrations, not even on the cover. Later pulp magazines would include illustrated covers and some illustrations inside, usually at the top of a page or a one-page spread, and then the rest being just words. But nowhere near what comic books would have once they were developed. These pulps were in a basic sense short stories in a paperback magazine format, or a radio show in print, if you will. Many of the pulp heroes during this era were the Shadow, who introduced many other pulp heroes to the public, as well as the Spider, the Black Bat, and Doc Savage. For the most part, pulp heroes were ordinary people who chose to go on extraordinary adventures or fight crime. Most of them didn't have any superpowers to speak of, but instead would use guns, disguise, whips, etc. in battle. Unlike the comic book heroes of today, pulp heroes weren't above killing either. On many occasions, the Shadow would choose to kill his enemies, so they didn't have the chance to escape conviction to commit evil acts again. Genres of pulp magazines included, but aren't limited to, adventure, crime, fantasy, horror, sci-fi, noir, westerns, romance, etc. Comic books, on the other hand, are what pulp magazines evolved into, beginning with daily and weekly newspaper comic strips. Comics consist of art which is organized into sequential, juxtaposed panels to represent individual scenes. Each panel contains either narration or dialogue between characters. The first modern comic book was Famous Funnies, which was released in 1933, which reprinted earlier newspaper humor comic strips. So what's the difference between pulp heroes and comic book heroes? Well, technically nothing, especially since the majority of pulp heroes cross over into comic books after pulp magazines became obsolete. The main difference is that creators could get away with a lot more during the pulp era, since there weren't many, if any, illustrations or art to go along with the stories. It forced the reader to use their imagination. So while a specific scene could be described horrifically with blood and guts, etc., there was no art to go along with it. So parents many times wouldn't catch on if they flipped through their child's magazine. Pulp heroes were described to the reader rather than being presented to them dramatically in a mighty savior style pose as comic book heroes are presented. It was also often easier to leave the reader with a cliffhanger at the end of the story since there were no images to give away the ending. So there you have it, guys. The difference between pulp heroes and comic book heroes is there really isn't a difference other than the way they're presented to the reader. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out on future videos. Also, don't forget to like, comment, and share with your family and friends. I'm Shannon for ComicGen TV. Take care.